Also on the Crime Watch, investigators in Santa Cruz have stopped what they believe could have been a violent escape from the Santa Cruz County Jail involving the convicted felon Maurice Ainsworth. Action News reporter Phil Gomez has details tonight. He's live in Santa Cruz. Phil?
Well, Dan, Maurice Ainsworth already facing a lengthy prison term, apparently figures he's got nothing to lose, planned to escape from the Santa Cruz County Jail using a shank, a jail-made knife, to injure or even kill a correctional officer, then impersonate a guard and walk out the front doors of the jail to an awaiting car.
He will be handled differently. He will be dressed differently. And he will have additional officers with him when he is moved.
26-year-old Maurice Ainsworth was already being handled differently in the Santa Cruz County Jail after his last escape attempt. But now he's being watched even more carefully. A routine inspection of his cell turned up a shank and a note documenting how he planned to escape.
He would impersonate an officer in order to leave the jail and possibly collude with someone outside the facility to assist him in his escape. That it involved either injuring or killing an officer to do so, and that he would receive some outside help in doing this.
No accomplice has been arrested because Ainsworth never got to act out his escape plan. Earlier this year, a jury convicted him of 39 counts when he attempted to escape while receiving treatment at Dominican Hospital. He beat a female deputy, terrified a nursery school, and kidnapped a Russian couple. It's a conviction that could mean he'll spend the rest of his life in prison.
The recommended sentence by our office is that he be sentenced to serve a determinate term of 189 years, and consecutive to that, a term which would be 8 life sentences, which would be 56 years to life, consecutive to the 189 years.
Ainsworth was not present in court when the latest escape plan was revealed. He's considered too big a security risk.
When an escape plot such as this is uncovered and it involves, you know, a serious assault or the murder of an officer to do so, necessary precautions need to be taken.
I think the reasonable inference would be that he feels that he has absolutely nothing to lose and as a result is willing to engage in this type of violent conduct.
Ultimately, it'll be up to the judge to determine how much time Ainsworth will serve in prison. He was scheduled to be sentenced later this month, but it was rescheduled for April 26th. Dan and Aaron.
All right. Thank you very much, Phil. The DA's office isn't planning on charging Ainsworth for the latest incident. Instead, they don't want Ainsworth to get any credit for good behavior. They've got him sentenced, and then they want to get him out to state prison just as quickly as they can.